Sri Gurubhyo Namaha. Those were the days when India was under the British rule. Colleges were opened to introduce Western education. Bombay, Madras, and Calcutta universities came into being in 1857, followed by two more at Lahore and Allahabad. Indians were not allowed in research works by foreign scientists. In the end of 19th century, three great names from India emerged in physics, chemistry, and mathematics. Jagadish Chandra Bose in physics, Prafulla Chandra Ray in chemistry, and Srinivasa Ramanujan in mathematics. These three are called the trailblazers. Coming to Srinivasa Ramanujan, he was born in the year 1887, December 22nd. Young Ramanujan grew up in an atmosphere of strong religious faith and orthodox values. The religious influence was so strong that Ramanujan felt many of his actions were predetermined by the family deity Lakshmi Namagiri goddess. He is the sole example of a modern Indian scientist for whom religion was not a thing apart from his professional life. The most decisive influence in his life was that of his mother, who had a flair for mathematics. She made good use of it in preparing horoscopes and making astrological calculations. Ramanujan, however, at the age of 12, his uncanny feel for numbers began to be obvious. Before he came across Loni's trigonometry, he had worked out many of the concepts and was terribly disappointed when he realized that these were already well known. The teachers did not know what to do with the boy who always asked odd questions. When the teacher said during class that any number divided by itself equals 1, Ramanujan asked if the same rule would apply in the case of 0 divided by 0. One day, he saw a vendor selling sweets for an anna each. As he watched the sale of a set of sweets for 8 annas, the idea of arithmetic and geometric series suddenly flashed upon him. That was the way his mind worked. The headmaster of that school often assigned to him the duty of making up class timetables. At the age of 13, he had already worked out the relations between circular and exponential functions. When he was in the sixth form, he came across a textbook on algebra, trigonometry, calculus, and analytical geometry. It made a deep impression upon him. Every formula in the book was a source of delight. He worked on them, found proofs of his own. The book was, in fact, of a very conventional nature, but it provided the right kind of stimulus to his unusual. Srinivasa Ramanujan was living in a world where positive integers and formulas were the only realities. Mathematics was the only subject which interested him. Other subjects were neglected to such an extent that he failed in the first year. He returned home without a degree. While he was being branded a failure, his mathematical powers were growing. His mind was active, thinking out and solving problems, filling up notebook after notebook. In his middle class orthodox family, nobody was able to appreciate his talents. He was considered a freak. Ramanujan continued to work on his own. His first paper was published in 1911. The next year, he got a clerical job at the Madras Port Trust office for ₹25 only per a month to feed his family. He had nobody to guide him or initiate him in modern mathematics, but he found a sympathetic friend there in the Port Trust. He was encouraged by S.S. Iyer and sent 120 theorems to Professor G.H. Hardy, a famous mathematics professor in Cambridge University. Hardy was amazed to receive such original work from an unknown Indian clerk and made a concentrated effort to get him a fellowship in Cambridge. However, Srinivasa Ramanujan reached England in the year 1914 by the efforts of Professor Hardy. Cambridge provided a congenial atmosphere for his work, and he soon became well known there. He was given an honorary degree and was made a fellow of the Royal Society in 1918. His association with Hardy proved to be a mutually rewarding experience. Hardy was curiously drawn to Ramanujan, so unlike himself in culture and habit, they worked together, each supplementing the other. Ramanujan was far from the Western idea of a rational being. Peculiarly, though Hardy was an atheist, and it is surprising how he formed a bond of understanding with a Hindu who spoke openly of his belief in gods and goddesses. Ramanujan's best papers were written jointly with Hardy. During his stay at Cambridge, Ramanujan fell seriously ill. The illness was diagnosed to be tuberculosis in a fairly advanced stage. Ramanujan, however, continued working. The doctors knew that his days were numbered and advised him to return to India so that he could spend his last days among his own people. He came back to India in the year 1919. At that time, Hardy came to India to see Ramanujan in a taxi. The taxi number was 1729. Hardy said that his taxi number was 1729, which has no any significance. Then, immediately, Srinivasa Ramanujan responded and said, "It is the least positive integer, which can be expressed as the sum of two cubes in two different ways. 1729 equal to 10 cube plus 9 cube. 1729 equal to 12 cube plus 1 cube. However, his disease grew steadily worse, and Srinivasa Ramanujan left this world on 26th April 1920 at the age of 32 years only. Tamil Nadu government declared his birthday December 22nd as State Technical Day. In 1962, the Indian government released a postal stamp on his 75th birthday. In the year 2012, Manmohan Singh, then Prime Minister of India, declared December 22nd as National Mathematics Day. And in the year 2014, the Indian government declared National Mathematics Year as 2014. Finally, let us remember the words of sentences of Jagadish Chandra Bose, one of the trail blazer. He said, "One had a sense of purpose and determination. Closed doors would open and the impossible would become a reality." This is true in the case of Srinivas Ramanujan. Let us, the young Indians, especially mathematics interested persons, take him as a model and try to reach higher places. Thank you, one and all.